G'day critters, welcome back to the channel. We're back with more Critical Role content, and we're going to continue this theme of music that I told you about. Like I said, next up we got Your Turn to Roll. We're getting into that today. I've been excited to get into it based off I already liked all the music from the animated series that we've already watched, but based off your comments, you guys let me know that it's even more beasty with the lyrics added to it. I've just heard the audio from the outro of these behind the scene videos that we've already seen, so we're gonna get into this. I'm excited. Once again, thank you all for dropping links. I know some of them get blocked, or most of them do get blocked, just because YouTube doesn't trust them. And Signo, I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing your name right, but correct me in the comment section if I'm wrong. But thank you. You gave me the link for this video we're going to watch today, which is the announcement for the Kickstarter. You gave me the animated link, and you gave me the link for the behind the scenes for Your Turn to Roll, I believe. I'm not sure what the difference between all of them is, but we'll get into them. If behind the scenes is short enough, we might combine it with this one. We'll see. But nonetheless, I'm excited to get into this one. This one is the one I chose mainly because it's a little bit longer, and it looks like we have the actual actors, voice actors, acting out like scenes. I don't know, it looks a little goofy, so it looks funny. We'll get to see a little bit more of their character, so I'm excited to get into this one and hear the music. So let's get straight into it.
Hey Travis, make a cartoon. I mean, with the success of the comic book, a cartoon is a no-brainer.
Imagine my face, but animated.
Animation. I want to voice Grog.
Want to write some scripts?
I'm dumb.
For a cartoon?
I love
animation.
Do they do any other acting other than voice acting?
I had a dream that Critical Role is making.
Like live action beside the game.
Animated special.
Mm-hmm. Go back to sleep.
The we'll magic pajamas. The
no. Now, rise and shine, everyone! Burn out of my voice!
That's a big ass bed. I wouldn't be surprised if they all actually sleep in that bed. That bed as close as they all are.
A Critical Role, a bunch of nerdy ass voice actors.
And today we are thrilled to announce our 45-day campaign for a Critical Role animated special.
They hit it before
now, this
that.
Has been highly requested, and believe me, for 5 years it's been our dream to tell these stories in animation. Now, with your support, we're gonna make that dream a reality and fund a fully animated half-hour special starring the original characters from our first campaign.
Yeah, we are calling it The Legend of Vox Machina.
Oh my God.
So how long were you guys requesting it before they actually kicked off this Kickstarter?
Hold that beer.
No. Hold your horses,
why?
Okay?
What's wrong?
No, I mean, some folks might not know who the hell we are.
Point. For those who are not familiar, Critical Role is a live role-playing show that streamed on Thursday nights, featuring us, a group of best friends who happen to be professional voice actors. Now, this show has inspired millions of people to create incredible fan art and spread the love of storytelling to a whole new generation. Now, this amazing community has come to be known as the Critters. You know who you are.
And the Critters have inspired us to tell our stories in books, live events, even a Dark Horse comic book series.
I didn't know they had
so,
like full feature
say,
books.
We're pretty stoked to finally take the next big step and make an animated special.
So without further ado, let's roll that.
Not yet.
I like how they keep
they still don't know
hinting
about
at it
our
with
creative
the role. Mm-hmm.
We're not animators, but we happen to know some folks who are pretty good at it.
Are we drawing this f***ing cartoon or what?
Tim Knox. Nice.
It's got action, it's got comedy, it's got drunkenness.
Ooh, they did Ninja Turtles.
It's got everything.
We are also bringing in one of the busiest animation writers in the biz to help craft a brand new adventure for Vox Machina.
Your mom uses spell check. Listen, I've been doing this a while and I know what you guys want me to say. No, I'm not giving any spoilers. All I can say is that it is going to be in canon and it takes place before the streaming show started. Also, the bad guy is going to be revealed to be none other than...
Nice.
That was close. And how about the voices?
Was that much of a surprise to you guys when they actually announced that? Did you guys already know who the bad guy was going to be? If you already watched the campaign, I'm assuming you did.
We'll be joined by some special celebrities.
But they just wanted to keep it a secret.
Yeah. It's an all-star lineup. Roll the freaking clip.
No, not yet. We still need to explain why we need the campaign in the first place.
Hey guys, I'm sorry to interject, but I've been crunching some numbers.
I was about
here.
To say, where's
one
she
minute
at?
Of TV quality animation costs between $30,000 to $50,000.
What?
And our
what?
Budget, $750,000 is way more than any media company wanted to take a chance on, especially since our show is about a fantasy adventuring group named Vox Machina.
For a minute? You know, based $50K, off of what the hell?
Game. Which means we need you to help fund animators, background artists, character designers, sound and picture editors, storyboarders, music, special effects.
I kind of like that design of Scanlan. I like what we ended up getting, but that looked cool. He just looked a little bit bigger.
Sure, we can get there. Because after all, I do play a forensic scientist on TV, so I know what I'm talking about.
Thanks, Ash. And with that, it is time to finally show you what we have been working on. Laura, why don't you do the...
Roll out!
Oh, yeah, you guys did tell me that Marisha's been in, like, Marvel stuff. So, oh, let me shut up. Ooh, I like that animation. And they rise from the flames for the battles ahead. Villains beware, cause you're about to be dead. Oh, I love that beat. I'm always a fan of bass, but I love everything going on. I could definitely see the X-Men inspiration. Hold on. Was that supposed to be Silas and Delilah? That's good. That's good. Wait, was this their first time hearing that too?
We probably should have led with that.
No, it's cool. I like it.
We wouldn't be Critical Role if we didn't have some awesome swag for you guys. So we'll be rolling out all kinds of campaign-specific rewards. Nice. And the higher up you go, the more we can unlock. Mm.
Remember, if you can't contribute, you can still support us by sharing the campaign with your rich-ass friends. Like me.
Yes, and keep checking back. We will be posting updates with artwork, animation, progress reports all along the way. You can expect the final delivery of The Legend of Vox Machina in the fall of 2020. Mm,
I feel bad I didn't like donate to it. I didn't know about it, but...
With your generosity, we can come full circle back to our roots in voiceover animation. Thank you for sharing our excitement and your support of this project.
Good day, friends!
That's awesome. Every day. Oh, that's awesome. That was 7 minutes. It felt like it went by so fast. That was cool to see. So once again, another great video. I'm gonna cycle through this video again because I feel like there's some things that I want to go back and watch. I'm gonna do it right now with you guys. Like at the beginning when all their faces were popping up and they're just kind of whispering to Grog in his dream. I'm always gonna call him by their animated character, by the way. It's just easier to remember. I want to go back and see what some of those tweets said. I'm assuming, I don't know if they were from I think they were just from like fans of the campaigns. Hold on, let's see if I could pause it right on the spot. Like one says, I'll see if I can pop it up on the screen as I'm reading them, but I'm pledging to this Kickstarter if I have to donate a kidney. And I feel like that's true. You only need one of them, right? Let's see. Travis didn't even finish his sentence before I shouted, shut up and take my money. Critical Role. See, a lot of this stuff I already knew. What they said based on the behind the scenes stuff I already watched and what you guys have told me. So that's awesome. 5 years in the making, like they said, them being voice actors and starting this from the point of this video. And then I don't know how long it took you guys as critters to kind of catch on and just be so hyped about it that you were clamoring and begging for animated series. It sounds like that was always in the plans for them. As a goal to eventually start this, or at least after a while, because I know it was just for a birthday party for fun, but after a while, after it caught steam a little bit, it seems like it became a goal pretty early on to have this animated series. I wonder how far along that was. So that's cool to see. Hold on, I want to read one more of these tweets. Another one says, I'm just going to sit back and join everyone in rapidly losing our fucking minds about animated Vox Machina. Critical Role. I love it. I love it. I know this video has 1.1 I think 1.9 million views or something. So I know they were getting flooded with videos like this. And you guys already told me how fast you raised the money for this campaign already. I didn't realize going in how expensive it was to create like 50K for a minute of animation. I guess that's me simplifying it a little bit, but because there's a lot of stuff that goes into that 1 minute, all the drawing, the music, that takes into account everything. So I guess that makes sense, but it just didn't register until they actually put the number on the screen. So the fact that they did that was actually pretty smart. Not you guys would have supported regardless, but them to do that, even bringing in new people to want to commit like their money to it, I think that was a smart move on their part. There was a couple more things I wanted to see. Familiar faces with Titmouse and production. I think there was something with the dragon at the... Oh, the comic books. I didn't realize that... you guys might have mentioned it to me in the comments, but I just haven't seen them because there's so many of you guys. But I didn't realize that there was like actual... What did they call them? Dark World or Dark Book comic books? They look awesome, and they all kind of look like they actually have different... this looks like some spoiler shit. I ain't gonna lie, I don't know what I'm looking at, but this one on the far right, this little red-faced dragon, I don't know who that is. He looked dope. Damn, Scanlan, the smallest hell in this. But yeah, they all look like different animations. Everything looks dope. Grog looks amazing. Keyleth always looks dope. Vex and Vax. Actually, you know what? I saw something with them later on in this. Ooh, what's this little... Oh, questions. This little, I don't know, amphibious thing with the like webbed ears in the second book. I don't know. Are we... Oh my gosh. I hope we get to see all this stuff like in the animation. Now, another question is, I know it's already been picked up for a second season, but are fans gonna kickstart, or are they gonna run another Kickstarter to fund it, or it has Amazon already been all in and they're paying for everything, or at least a majority of production, because they have faith in it now? It's kind of messed up that they had to prove themselves after 5 years of building this fan base, and I'm sure they saw like the following that they had at this point already. But nonetheless, just a quick question. I wonder if they're, because like I said, I feel bad that I didn't, I know at that point, or up until now, I didn't really know about the Kickstarter. I feel bad I didn't kind of become a Patreon of something that I've been enjoying so much. I don't know. How long have we been reacting to this show, this content? Probably for the last few months, maybe. I've just been enjoying the content, and I'm definitely gonna have to get some merchandise to at least show a little bit of support. It looks like they got everything. They got like necklaces. I think Percy was wearing. It looks like Marisha's wearing one. Keyleth, but I don't know if that's a Critical Role necklace. That might just be her own swag. I don't know. And then Jennifer was funny when I think she said like your mom doesn't know how to spell check or something like that. That was funny. She was about to drop a spoiler. Now I asked again, if you guys, I know there's a lot of different sections to the campaigns, but I wonder, did you guys already know going in before? It seems like they were just teasing a little bit. Did you guys know that it was going to be Silas and Delilah or not? And I think in this animation, in the actual music, it feels so weird because this was all about the music video in the Your Turn to Roll teaser, which I loved, by the way. You're right, with the lyrics it's even more better, or it's much better, but that beat is what does it for me. It just gets my heart pumping a little bit, and I don't know what it is. Maybe it is the fact that it brings me back nostalgically to like X-Men and stuff like that. You guys said it was inspired by like 80s theme based on Scanlan, what or the sound that Scanlan was going for. I love it. It's amazing. But I don't know if I would do anything to change it. As far as the animation with the music, it looked dope. I actually really like it. I couldn't tell you. It's a little bit more cartoony. than I was expecting, but I like that look. I'm curious if you guys prefer that to what we got in the final animation. I actually like the, for what we got, the tone of the series, the animated series. I feel like the more sharp and less cartoony caricatures of the characters fits the tone a little bit better. So I like what we ended up getting, but this I wouldn't have been mad at either. And it looks like the comic books has even a little bit different animation or drawing style. So let me know. Actually, let me know. And I wonder if it differs between campaigns, like if Mighty Nine has a different style and all that. You guys will have to let me know, like, what's your favorite. I feel like if you guys told me, I'd be able to Google it, and it wouldn't be spoilers if I just, like, looked up, like, not even fan art, maybe, of what your favorite drawing style or animation is. Because I just love seeing all that stuff. That's really cool. But yeah, I like that. I said a couple more things, actually. Try not to keep you guys too long. I know you guys enjoy these regardless, but there was a scene with it confused me. I didn't say anything during the reaction. I'm trying to pause right on it. Hold on, I'm gonna press play while we're listening to it. You guys can probably hear that. Hold on, Keyleth. Right here. And then Vex and Vex. I thought it was funny because I was looking and then I looked at the names and you can't really tell which name which name they assign to which character. So if you're like new, if I was first watching this before I first watched the animated series, I wouldn't be able to tell because of the, I guess it's an ongoing joke you guys have told me about that everybody always confuses their name of which is which. So I got confused for a minute. I was like, is that Vex? I had to think about it for a second. So that was funny. Just freeze framing on it makes it even cooler to see. So there was one more thing. Grog was next. Scanlan always looks dope. Delilah and Silas. I'm surprised they... because everybody looks pretty similar to their character model from this animation to the final animated series, except for Delilah and Silas, who I'm assuming that is in this teaser. I don't know who else it would be. Unless, hold on, is she turning into a dragon in this damn? Yeah, hold on. Is that Silas and Delilah? Hold up. What am I watching? is this spoiler territory? I don't know. We'll see. I don't know. I'm going to keep watching it because I think she just turned into a dragon. And hold up. And this dragon at the end, this is the last thing I noticed. It's got like, I'm calling it a dragon. I don't know exactly what it is, but it's got arms coming out of like its hips. And I don't know what that means. And then, it looks like, I don't know if this is like an upgrade for Keyleth, but it looks like on her staff, she's got like a residual crystal on it. Is she going to get, are they going, can they all get residual? Or just her maybe, since she has that nature power and all that? I don't know. Maybe some things give me hints towards future seasons. I don't know exactly what I'm looking at, but it looks cool. So I don't know. And it's just cool to see like their reaction. This probably wasn't. Ooh, I just noticed that I think they might have put his name up there before too. I'll have to go back and see. But Trinket's in the background. I'm trying to look in the background and see what else is back there. Nothing else that I really recognize. Who is this? I'm looking like, I don't know if you guys can see that, but in the bottom right corner of the shelf, there's like a green face ghoul or goblin. I don't know what it is. I can't tell. I don't know, but is this, I take it. I wonder what set this is. They've got their camera set up and everything. Was this the set for campaign one? I see a little shield in the background. It looks like it's got an M on it. I don't know what all this. I'm gonna be excited to see all this stuff when we watch the live streams. But yeah, that's it for as far as this one goes. I don't know how long I went. I know you guys enjoyed. I've given you guys hour long videos and you've sat through them and loved them. So I don't know that I'll combine it with this one. But I'm still gonna do the Your Turn to Roll making of, which I'm excited to get into too. So this was another fun one. It never disappoints. Your Turn to Roll behind the scenes next, and then I think. Sorry, but thank you for dropping the link to this one. I would have went with just the animated version to avoid spoilers at first, but I'm glad you gave me this one because it gave me a lot of. I'm probably gonna cycle through this video just to see everything or anything I may have missed, to give me hints towards the next season, and combine it with things you guys have told me in the comic books. You guys know I like to play detective and ask questions and get excited for things to come. So this was dope. Another dope video. I loved it. And I hope you guys love the reaction. I guess I'll catch you in the next one. Drop those links. I know I don't see all of them or comment on all of them because YouTube doesn't like them. They block them. So I go back and I usually click on the ones of people I've seen in the comment section before, just so I know I can trust them. But I appreciate you guys and all your help. So Your Turn to Roll behind the scenes next. And then what was the next one? I know you guys said Darrington Brigade. I'm thinking I don't know. I haven't checked the time length on that one yet. I'm thinking it's over an hour or two maybe. So I'll probably divide it up into like 30 minute reactions maybe. Let me know what you guys will be feeling as far as that goes. But nonetheless, drop your comments, hit that like button, subscribe. If you haven't already, share the video. I appreciate you guys. Love yourselves. Love one another. I'll catch you in the next one, critters. Deuces.